Good evening and welcome to our NSCG main awards ceremony. As you know, things are a little different at the moment, but here at Newcastle, we were determined not to let a worldwide pandemic stop us from celebrating the success of our many talented students, apprentices, and the fantastic employers that we work with. So tonight we have our first virtual ceremony, and I hope you enjoy it. Of course, nothing can quite replace the atmosphere of us all celebrating together at the same venue. But we've tried to include many of the things that are traditions in our main celebration. For example, we still have the element of surprise, as tonight's students and employers know they've won an award, but don't know which one yet. We still have a number of special guests joining us who have pre-recorded short videos, and we have musical interludes and college videos to share during the evening. We try to make the day a little special for all the award winners by dropping a little celebration box at your doorstep earlier today. I hope the postal arrangements work well and that you save some of the chocolates to keep you going tonight. Finally, our event has been live streamed on our Facebook channel. So if you happen to have a smart TV, don't forget you can watch us on the big screen and not just on a phone or laptop. Of course, if you're watching on a big screen, please remember the TV adds at least £10. Before we hear from our first special guest, I'd like to say a little bit about the 1920 academic year. It was all going so very well. In the autumn term, we had our first full Ofsted inspection as a merged college and on the new Ofsted framework. And if you haven't already heard, it went spectacularly well for us. NSCG achieved outstanding in every single category, 9 in total. The first college in the country to achieve such an accolade. This is a good point to pay tribute to my brilliant and talented staff team who work so hard, not just for the Ofsted week, but day in, day out, always putting our students first. I'm sure everyone watching tonight would like to join me in acknowledging their efforts. How does the saying go? Pride comes before a fall. Our students were set to achieve the best results ever for our college, and the spring term saw students making great progress towards their final examinations. Unfortunately, the awful COVID-19 worldwide public health crisis has meant we have all had a very different and entirely unexpected finish to the 2020 academic year. And closing the college on March the 20th was one of the saddest days in my entire working career. I'll just say a little bit about what we've been doing through the lockdown period. We kept our Newcastle site open for a small number of our vulnerable learners, providing transport from Stafford to bring students together for this period. These students have formed great bonds with each other and with the staff supporting them. And I'm sure when they look back on this period later in their lives, the good memories will far outweigh any anxieties about the wider health crisis. Of course, NSCG did their bit, providing PPE for our local hospital and care establishments, stripping the college supplies first, and then as more was needed, some of our engineering staff came in to manufacture visors using our 3D printer equipment. Thank you very much to them. We also raided our shop and kitchen supplies, making donations to depleted food banks, and of course, many of our students and staff volunteered to help support the NHS and the wider community in lots of different ways. Our support staff kept our support functions going throughout this period, either from home or by rota coming into college. And our student support team made virtually daily contact with the vulnerable learners who weren't able to attend college. Finally, our teachers. I said they were brilliant and talented earlier, and they haven't let me down. They have all stepped up to the plate, pushed themselves outside of their comfort zone, and extended their technological skills in order to continue contact with our students. In fact, we even volunteered to be part of an Ofsted review of remote learning. And an Ofsted inspector spent a packed 2 days in June virtually reviewing our approach, talking to staff, students, managers, and attending virtual lessons. And although this wasn't an inspection, she had found it an overwhelmingly positive review with staff and students who were a credit to the organisation. Her words, not mine. Throughout the entire period, our marketing team have had steam coming out of their machines. As in addition to the work producing several other virtual events, they've continually posted items illustrating that there's been a lot going on, with students assisting by contributing some great images, such as the Media Makeup Live Brief, the Student of the Month winner pictures, the Performing Arts Student Music Links, and the AOC Sport Awards, where NSCG won 3 out of the 6 categories. Fantastic. Staff teams continue to be recognised externally, with 2 curriculum areas shortlisted for national awards during lockdown: the sports team at Stafford and our Foundation Studies internship provision, both awaiting the outcome. And of course, don't forget that NSCG was shortlisted for the prestigious TES College of the Year Award. However, unfortunately, the event was to be held at the end of March, so we don't know what will happen with that one yet, but fingers crossed. As you can see, we've definitely made the best of a bad time, but remote learning cannot replace the real face-to-face classroom and wider college experience, and therefore we are hopeful that we can fully open for business next term, and we can't wait to see everybody together again. Now for our first special guest video. Lord Stafford was set to give out the main awards for our Stafford celebration. A great supporter of our college and someone who really cares about young people and their future success. Lord Stafford.
Hello, my name's Lord Stafford, and I'm so sorry I cannot be with you on your special evening tonight for your prize giving. Sadly, all of us have had to go through some difficult times during the last 8 weeks, but none more so than you, the students and the teachers, in having to learn online from home. I know that in as much that my daughter and daughter-in-law are both teachers, and I've seen the pressures that they have been under. So well done to get to where we are now, and I hope you have a thoroughly enjoyable evening. And as I said, I'm just so sorry I can't be with you. I have taken this opportunity, I've never done a live broadcast like this, to show you where I live and just to say a few words about what I do. Behind me here is the family home, which I inherited some 30 years ago from my father. And my role in life is to pass it on to the next generation. Every morning I look down here into the park for this wonderful view. And at the bottom end of the park, which you probably can't see, is where the original house was. Sadly, we kept choosing the wrong side and Cromwell burnt that down in 1640. And the house was then rebuilt here behind me in 1660, and then the Georgians put on our front in about 1730. So it's been in the family for 450 years. So although I own it, I actually really only feel it as a caretaker, and it's been lent to me to pass on to the next generation. Now, I didn't have a very good start in trying to achieve that, in that I went to university, but never got a degree. In fact, I got chucked out of university. My parents are so upset I got banished to Australia with £40 in my pocket and no one to meet me at the airport. Of course, in those days there were no mobile phones, so nobody knew where I was. So that was a really quite a quick growing up process. Anyway, 5 years ago, I was given the honour of being asked to be Chancellor at Staffordshire University. I didn't dare tell them I didn't have a degree. And one of the privileges is to attend their graduation ceremony, which is very similar to the prize giving which you're having tonight, obviously slightly bigger, but the excitement and the to award the achievements of everybody is exactly the same. It's also an opportunity to say thank you. Thank you to your parents and families for the love and support that they've given you, because without that, you wouldn't be here this evening. So look across, just say thank you. Also, I'm delighted, I gather that there are some apprentices and the employers with you. I've always been a great advocate of getting businesses to work with colleges and universities, because you get students with new and bright ideas going into companies and then learning what it's like to be in the workplace. So that's a wonderful collaboration. So I'm delighted that we have some apprentices tonight, and also to congratulate the employers for collaborating with the college. And finally, but not least, the unsung heroes, the staff and teachers at the college. It takes a huge amount to get a college of this size on different campuses to be working, and also for the teachers, for the work that they put in. They must be thrilled to see the fruits of their labours in the awards that some of you will receive tonight. So congratulations to all of them. One small bit of advice, work hard. I know that is the last thing you want to hear, having had such a terrible time these last few weeks, but anything of value needs working at, be it a relationship, be it something you're good at sports or the arts or education or in the workplace. Because if you work hard, then you will fulfill your ambitions. Also, there's every chance if you work hard that luck will come along and you're able to use it. If you sit around waiting for Lady Luck to appear, that won't happen. So work hard, and I hope that you have a tremendous amount of luck in doing that. I'm so excited. You are the future. Old duffers like me are going into the sunset, but you are the future. So congratulations. I'm really excited for you, and I hope you have a thoroughly enjoyable evening. I just have one more important task, and that's to press the right button to switch this off. So thank you very much for listening to me.
And now for our first short video showing life as an A-level student.
Good luck. A-levels aren't hard.
When the sharpest words wanna cut me down, I'm gonna send a blood, gonna drown a mind. I am brave, I am bruised, I am who I'm meant to be. This is me.
Okay, so right about now, in previous awards, I usually give very specific instructions on when to clap and when to stop clapping. Obviously, that's all out of the window tonight, so please feel free to clap, to holler, to jump up and down, and to celebrate the success of our fantastic students. We're starting our awards with the sixth form pathway, academic. And our first A-level creative arts winner is Jack Sproston. Described as an outstanding student in photography, Jack has produced the biggest and most thorough personal investigation his lecturer has ever seen. The outcome delivered amazing photo shoots, a brilliant photo book, and a 5-minute moving image titled What Makes a Man, combining theory, still life, documentary, and portraiture throughout his project. Expected to get top grades in all his subjects, Jack's talents have already been recognised by others as he received unconditional offers for all his university applications. In fact, at one interview, they said he probably didn't need to go to university, which is possibly not the best sales pitch. Fortunately, Jack sees the value in continuing his education and he's progressing to the West of England University to study photography. Well done, Jack. The Outstanding Achievement Award for Business and Professional Studies goes to Hannah Perry. Taking A-levels in accounting, psychology and business, Hannah has applied herself consistently well throughout her A-level studies, particularly in the field of accounting. Able to make intelligent links between different aspects of the syllabus, in addition to a very high level of numerical ability, Hannah is also able to express her ideas clearly in well-structured, extended written responses. Described by her teachers as a real pleasure to work with, she is a student who is enthusiastic, hard-working and conscientious. With a potential career in accounting in mind, Hannah hopes to progress onto an accounting apprenticeship, a fantastic route for this career choice. Congratulations, Hannah. The Outstanding Achievement in Humanities and Social Sciences Award goes to Lucy Pounte. Taking a mix of law and modern foreign languages in her A-level studies, Lucy is described by lecturers as simply an excellent student. With a clear focus on her studies, Lucy represented the college at the Kiel Modern Law Commission in 2019 and relished the opportunity to explore a variety of different careers within the legal field. A student with huge natural ability enhanced by her aptitude for independent study, she consistently strives to achieve high grades in all her subjects. Clearly busy in her studies, Lucy is also a sportswoman, competing for NSCG in our highly successful Academy of Sport volleyball team, who regularly compete at regional and national levels. For the next stage in her education, she is off to Liverpool University to study law. Well done, Lucy. The Outstanding Achievement in Science Award goes to Jamie Wallace. Always stiff competition for this award, but Jamie came out a worthy winner. Described as a calm yet self-confident young man with considerable academic gifts who always conducts himself in an exemplary manner. With a strong desire to study medicine, he has enthusiastically pursued all opportunities available to him to help realise his ambition, including participation in Kiel University's MedPrep initiative. He also did very interesting work as part of the Cambridge-sponsored HE Plus team, looking at the viability of bacteriophages as viable replacements for antibiotics. Very impressive. However, a medic today needs more than academic knowledge, and Jamie has a very genuine social conscience and a desire to contribute to society, reflected in his willingness to undertake a challenging work experience opportunity. Predicted top grades in his A-levels and extended project qualification, he is off to Kiel to study medicine next term, and we are confident he has a fantastic career ahead of him. Congratulations, Jamie. The Outstanding Achievement in Modern Foreign Languages goes to Matthew Dawswell, an outstanding and exceptionally industrious student who has consistently exceeded his targets in all his A-level subjects. All the more impressive as Matthew has had to cope with the very sad loss of a friend whilst at college. An accomplished pianist, it is for his undoubted abilities in his modern foreign language studies that he is receiving this award tonight. Going beyond in his linguistic studies, he delves deep into the cultural aspects of the countries in the languages he's studying, gaining a broader understanding of the people as well as their language. Next steps for Matthew, he plans to progress to University of Leeds to study languages and culture, a perfect combination. Good luck, Matthew. The Outstanding Achievement in Philosophy Award goes to Edward Sillitoe. Described by his lecturer as an exceptional philosophy student who has achieved top grades throughout the programme. A critical thinker who is quick to grasp philosophical concepts, Edward is also a key member of the philosophy reading group. He has completed 35 hours of work experience at Staffordshire Records Office and has supported the college at our open events as a student extra. Predicted top grades in all his subjects, Edward hopes to progress onto Nottingham University to study politics, philosophy and economics. Congratulations, Edward. The Outstanding Achievement in English Award goes to Daniel Dean. Predicted top grades in his English literature, history and government and politics A-level subjects, Daniel is described as a standout student who has a passion for literature. His English lecturer describes his writing as genuinely some of the finest work he has come across in his teaching career. As you might expect, Daniel reads widely beyond the set text, and his breadth of knowledge shows through in the points he makes. Part of the Honours Programme group, Daniel is also a key member of the Book Club and a student who was always supportive of others, willing to take the lead in open discussion. Daniel hopes to progress onto Oxford University to study English in an environment that will suit him very well. Many congratulations, Daniel. All students on our A-level programme have good GCSE grades and a variety of next step and career aspirations. The Honours Programme at NSCG is a tutorial and expanded enrichment programme for students who hope to progress onto the most competitive courses at the most competitive universities. Typically, all students have strong GCSE results and apply for a place on the Honours Programme early in their first term at college. As you can imagine, it is a tough decision deciding who gets the award in this category. This year, the Honours Programme award goes to Jack Heath. All Honours Programme students are academically very strong, and Jack is predicted top grades in his English literature, history, film studies, and extended project subjects. A highly competent historian, it is his passion for literature and the way he has enthusiastically embraced all the enrichment opportunities made available to him that make him stand out. Strong in debate, he is able to express complex ideas with clarity. For his history coursework, he researched the causes of the Second Anglo-Boer War, an unusual topic. But it is his passion for literature that has so impressed. With a particular interest in romantic poetry, his extended project titled The Elusive Literature, Poetry, Song, Lyrics and Their Connections was an exceptional piece of work. A regular contributor to the Book Club, he was part of the Rotary Club Youth Speaks public speaking competition and also part of the weekly Latin group. Without doubt, an impressive student in all aspects. Jack has a place at Cambridge University to study English. Fantastic, Jack, well done. The A-level award for special achievement goes to Jacob Lockett, a student with a real interest and passion for technology, particularly the automotive kind. Jacob came to us already having competed in the first Lego League competition, which we host at NSCG. His team were very successful and awarded the Young Engineers of the Year Award in 2017, winning regional finals again in 2018 and 2019 with us. A technowiz, Jacob runs an Instagram account and a YouTube channel with over 18,000 subscribers, posting professional videos and photographs of scale car replicas made out of Lego technique. He is particularly proud of the 1/10 scale remote control 4GT with realistic features. Already, he has had companies who have contacted him asking him to test and review their products. His interests and abilities combine a real car enthusiast together with someone who embraces the latest state-of-the-art technologies. Predicted top grades in his A-level subjects, Jacob intends to progress to Staffordshire University to study automotive and motorsport engineering. Congratulations, Jacob, and good luck. On to our next short video, showing life as a vocational student at NSCG. Head to head.
mama said, don't give up, it's a little complicated. All tied up, no more love, and I'd hate to see you waiting. Had to have high, high hopes for a living. Shooting for the stars, but I couldn't make a killing. Didn't have a time, but I always had a vision. Always had high, high hopes. Had to have high, high hopes for a living. Didn't know how, but I always had a feeling. I was gonna be that one in a million. Always had high, high hopes.
Our next category of awards acknowledges the outstanding achievements of our sixth form students who are on a vocational pathway. These are two-year level three pathways equivalent to three A-levels. Our first winner is in the category Outstanding Achievement for Business, goes to Juliana Sorica. Juliana is a highly professional, competent, high-achieving student. Indeed, she's already been successful in getting one of our High Flyer Awards last year, and she's a member of our Future Leaders programme. My memory of Juliana is actually attending an AOC, an Association of Colleges National Conference at the ICC in Birmingham in November, only to be tapped on the shoulder, and there was Juliana. She'd actually applied for a prestigious placement working at the ICC, helping to support a really significant event. And she looked so professional and did such a brilliant job for us. Juliana's next steps is a business and marketing course at MMU, and we wish her all the very best. Congratulations. Our next category is the Outstanding Achievement in Computing and IT, and goes to Heather Quigley. Heather started with us on a level two course, but was quickly fast-tracked onto the level three. A very successful student as part of her two-year studies, she's achieving top grades and has a real passion for a subject, and certainly we need more females in the area of computing and technology. Heather hopes to progress either onto an apprenticeship or onto higher level study, possibly here at NSCG, and we wish Heather all the very best. Our next category is the Outstanding Achievement Award in Creative Arts, and goes to Katie Jones. A skilled artist described by members of staff as an excellent all-round student, Katie has particular interest in developing her painting skills and has seen success already by being a winner in the Red Row competition in 2018. She wants to continue to expand her creative and artistic talents and will be coming back to us in September on the Foundation Diploma in Art and Design. Congratulations, Katie. Our next award is the Outstanding Achievement in Early Years, and goes to Abby White. Abby has worked particularly well on all aspects of her early years programme and has already achieved the PEP Award, which recognises success in placements as part of her two-year programme. Abby hopes to progress onto primary education at Staffordshire University, and we wish her good luck and hope to see her in a classroom with young people very soon. In our next category, we have two award winners. The first winner in the Outstanding Achievement Award in Engineering and Construction goes to Reuben Barker. Reuben is already a student that I've met. Indeed, he achieved the Student of the Month Award in this area in February. Fantastic student who works hard on his college studies, Reuben has also found himself a fantastic work experience place at Sigma RJ, and indeed for the last few months has combined a couple of days in the workplace alongside his college studies, which is absolutely fantastic. During lockdown, Ruben has continued to study hard, and like a lot of students up and down the college, they're regularly logging into Microsoft Teams and actually continuing their studies. His next steps, he hopes to move into employment, possibly onto a further or higher apprenticeship study. Good luck, Ruben. Our second winner in the Outstanding Achievement, Construction and Engineering, goes to Kyle Bedson. Kyle progressed onto his Level 3 Electrical Installation course after completing a Level 2 programme with us, and also successful in passing his GCSE maths, which is absolutely fantastic. Kyle has also done a 2-week placement at Bars Electrical and hopes to progress onto an apprenticeship and hopefully onto higher study when he leaves us this year. Good luck, Kyle. For our next category, the Outstanding Achievement Award in Health and Social Care goes to Bethany Woolridge. Beth has worked extremely hard throughout the 2 years of this very demanding programme. Staff say she's been a pleasure to teach. She's hardworking and highly motivated. She's been willing to undertake additional duties and represented students from the health and social care cohort at the recent learner conference earlier this year. Beth has managed to secure a place on children's nursing at Keele University, and we're really excited to hear about her training as she progresses. Good luck, Beth. Our next category is the Outstanding Achievement Award in Performing Arts and goes to Callum Mountford. A previous Star Search winner, I've seen Callum perform many times. In fact, if this had been a normal awards event, he would be on stage this evening. Callum is a fantastic guitarist. He writes his own songs and regularly performs on his own Facebook and YouTube channel, so check him out. We're hoping that he'll support our students here next year, helping them with their musical development. We're really excited to see what the future holds for Callum, a fantastic musician and a very worthy winner of this award. Well done, Callum. Our next category is the Outstanding Achievement in Public Services and goes to Dan Lucas. Dan was described as an easy choice for the Public Services Outstanding Achievement Award. Progressing from a Level 2 programme, he also has achieved a GCSE English along the way. Set to achieve top grades in his Level 3 Public Services programme, he's also been competing on the volleyball court for us in our highly successful men's volleyball team. Dan hopes to continue next year with us on the HNC in Public Services, and we look forward to seeing him in September. Congratulations. Our next category is the Outstanding Achievement Award in Science and goes to Sophie Roberts. Sophie is described as the definition of a model science student. She's excelled in every aspect of the course, and her work is always of the highest standard, most often at distinction level at the first attempt. All of her tutors agree that she's been a pleasure to teach, and we anticipate a future after she leaves us in the science field. Good luck, Sophie. Our next category is the Outstanding Achievement Award in Sport and goes to Jody Hume. Jody has demonstrated an outstanding attitude in all aspects of her studies, described as an exemplary student, someone who has consistently pushed herself to exceed her target grades. Passionate about sport, she's also described as someone who is a bit of a leader, and those skills she uses outside of college in her role as a swimming teacher. Her next steps, she hopes to progress on to Wrexham University to study rehabilitation and injury management. A really interesting and challenging course, and we wish Jody all the very best in the future. Our final category is the Sixth Form Vocational Special Award and goes to Chelsea Stevenson. Chelsea is a Level 3 Health and Social Care student with exemplary 100% attendance. Chelsea has taken part in a number of charity events, raising money for Young Minds and cancer research, whilst also carrying out work experience at Blackfriars Special School, working with children and young people. Chelsea's also been a student extra for us, supporting our open events. During lockdown, Chelsea was one of our first students to sign up for the NHS volunteer programme, and it's testament to her caring nature that she wants to progress in the area of care when she leaves us in September, going on to Huddersfield University to study youth and community work. And we wish you every success, Chelsea. Well done. And now it's time for our first musical number. Becky Morell is one of our talented performing arts lecturers, and she's singing first tonight a song that's particularly poignant, Somewhere Over the Rainbow.
Sky.
blue.
To our next category of awards called progression programmes. Students winning in these categories often spend a number of years with us at NSCG, progressing through the levels onto different programmes. The Outstanding Achievement Award at foundation level goes to Chloe Green. Chloe is currently on a Level 1 Vocational Health and Social Care programme, having previously completed an Entry 3 level with us. Excellent attendance, Chloe is someone who strives for top grades, and next year she hopes to progress onto a Level 2 Health and Social Care course here at NSCG. Well done, Chloe. The second winner in the Outstanding Achievement Foundation Level category goes to Bethany Jones. Bethany's actually been at NSCG for 5 years, and I think it's fair to say that at the start of her studies, it was a little bit of a challenge. Those days are long gone, and Bethany is now part of our award-winning internship programme and has been working with the support of her coach at McDonald's. She's been doing really well. Unfortunately, the lockdown period has paused that particular experience for Bethany, but we're hoping that it can restart very soon because I know Bethany is eager to get back to work. Good luck, Bethany. Our third winner in the Outstanding Achievement Foundation Level category is Dorothy Hegarty. Dorothy, or Dotty as she's known, is described by staff as an excellent student who works to the best of her ability at all times. And this work has continued throughout the lockdown period, which is particularly challenging in what is an intensely practical programme. Staff say she's a fantastic hairdresser in the making, and the next steps for Dotty are Level 2 hairdressing here with us in September. Our next category, the Outstanding Achievement Award at Intermediate Level, goes to Trinity Harvey. It's fair to say that Trinity has had challenges in life, and due to recent bereavements, Trinity has been living with her brothers. That's not impacted on her studies. She's an incredibly positive force within her tutor group and routinely displays acts of genuine generosity and support for all. A committed student who produces artwork of a very high standard, she hopes to progress onto Level 3 Games Design with us in September, and we look forward to seeing you back in college sometime soon. Well done. The second winner in the Outstanding Achievement Intermediate Level category goes to Harry Davis. Harry is currently studying the Level 2 AAT Foundation Diploma in Accounting. Teachers describe him as highly committed, someone who produces excellent results and has high levels of attendance, need I say more. He hopes to progress onto his Level 3 AAT accounting programme in September, and that bodes well as he's already achieved 100% in one of his AAT accounting examinations. So well done, Harry. Our next category is the Progression Pathway Special Achievement Award and goes to Hannah Jackson. Hannah is described by her teachers as genuine, honest, caring, and supportive of her peers. Hannah particularly stood out when supporting children and older adults attending our Christmas afternoon tea event. The visiting staff and service users thought that she was simply brilliant. So much so that she was offered employment opportunities as a result. But she had to turn them down because she was already on placement and doing extremely well at Northwood Day Centre. Next year, she hopes to progress onto Level 3 Health and Social Care. Congratulations. Now on to our Cross College Awards. Current government policy for 16 to 19 year olds has a big focus on English and maths achievement. What that means is if you haven't got a GCSE in maths or English at grade 4 or above when you come to college, you will need to continue to attend lessons and to take qualifications in these subjects alongside your main programme of study. It's fair to say that not all students relish this part of their programme. In this category, we recognise the significant progress a number of students make in these important English and maths GCSE subjects. The award for progression in English goes to Rax Aurora. Rax has a severe hearing loss and uses two cochlear implants. He also lip reads in class in addition to using a radio aid. Through his English studies with us, his written English has really improved. His staff are really pleased with his progress and he is striving to get highest grades. He completes additional work above and beyond what's expected in the classroom. And during lockdown, he's continued to engage with his English studies. Rax's main programme at the moment is the Level 2 Extended Certificate in Engineering. And fingers crossed, he's able to progress to the Level 3 programme in Engineering next year. And we have everything crossed in August that he gets what he wants and what he richly deserves in his GCSE English. Well done, Rax. The second Cross College Award for Progress in English goes to Denisa Hangoniova. Denisa is described by her English teacher as having a flair for evaluating and analysing text. She's shown real progress during this year and has done exceptionally well in her mock examinations. We have everything crossed that Denisa is successful in August and we hope to see her in September on the Level 3 Health and Social Care programme. Congratulations. The award for progress in maths goes to Fatia Islam. Fatia is currently on a Level 3 Early Years programme. She's in her first year after progressing from a Level 2 course where she was successful in achieving her GCSE English qualification. She's now got her head down and is working very hard on her GCSE maths. Her teachers in the maths area describe her as a model student with full attendance. And she's also been continuing to study during the lockdown period. We're hopeful that she finds success in August and we hope to see you back in September on the second year of your Level 3 qualification. Congratulations. Our second winner in the Award for Progress in Maths goes to Kelsey Thursfield. Kelsey is on a Level 3 Travel and Tourism programme and is also taking GCSE Maths alongside her main course. Described by a teacher as somebody who is working exceptionally hard, she's also able to find time to explain to her peers when in the classroom. Since lockdown, she's completed every piece of work to a high standard and fully engaged in Maths Watch programme. We have everything crossed that you find success in the August examinations and we look forward to seeing you next year. Congratulations. Our next Cross College Award recognises adult achievement from any part of the college. And this year goes to a student on the full-time Access programme. The Access course is a tough and extremely intensive course aimed at preparing adults to progress onto higher education. Often students on this course have been out of education for a number of years. The Adult Student of the Year goes to Sheena Wold. Sheena has made a huge contribution to college life on her adult course. She's worked incredibly hard and is set to achieve top grades in her access units. She pushes herself academically and is always enthusiastic and conscientious in her work. In addition, Sheena has helped us as a college extra, helping to give support and guidance to students considering coming to study at NSCG. Progressing on to an extremely demanding programme of social work at Keele University, we wish Sheena all the very best and congratulations on winning your award. The final award in our cross-college category is the Extra of the Year Award. Extras are our very important student ambassadors. They help out at many important college functions, particularly critical at our open events. In this role, students are extremely influential in helping potential applicants and their parents decide whether NSCG is the right place for them. Therefore, it's a vital job for us. The winner of the Extra of the Year Award goes to Brian Simpson. Brian has been extremely keen to engage with all aspects of college life, in addition to working extremely hard on his access programme. He was unanimously nominated to become the class rep and as such has represented the Access adult learners in course meetings and the learner conference. But it is his work as a college extra that we recognise in these awards, helping out at open events and helping to give advice and guidance to potential students who may be coming to us in September. His dedication to our college this year has been outstanding. Brian is hoping to progress onto teacher training at Staffordshire University, where I'm sure he will get involved in wider university life as part of his course. Well done, Brian, and thank you very much for your support. Now on to our next special guest, Carol Shanahan. Carol was meant to be giving the main awards at our Newcastle event. She is co-owner of Port Vale Football Club, coming to their rescue last year. With a supporter and wider community focus, Port Vale has really started to find success and was potentially in the running for the playoffs this year. Unfortunately, not to be, but a strong top half finish is a good basis to push on next season. Carol is also a director of Synectic Solutions, an IT company now based in Burslem. And Carol will tell you a little bit about how she got into computing during her video.
Hello everyone, it's Carol Shanahan here. I understand that with the current coronavirus situation that your college year has been cut short, but it's brilliant that you've still got the opportunity to celebrate all the achievements. And you mustn't forget the achievements that you've had for your students, the apprentices and the employers. And so now we can have a virtual awards evening online. As you can see, that is not where I am. I am currently at Port Vale, and it's a beautiful sunny day. And so you're just gonna have to view that when you're sat at home watching the awards ceremony. I've been asked to speak, as I have done on a few occasions for the college, to you students, to sort of really say how well done that I feel that you've worked so hard, and this year in particular has been where you've had to suddenly cut short, and what you've been through since. I think you've got to be really kind to yourselves. Of what this corona lockdown has meant to you as people finishing this part of your education and moving on to your next. When you look to my education, and when I look back to when I was young, I didn't have the advantages that you've got because I never had an award ceremony either online or anywhere else because I'm afraid that I didn't engage in education at all. I often say that my best talent was truancy, and on that I was superb. And to be fair, it taught me a lot of skills which I've taken on into later life, although I don't advocate it because it was not the easiest way to go. So I left school without any qualifications. So for that, I am really impressed and really jealous of what you guys have done. And what I had to do was then talk my way into jobs. And I think that there's a lesson in there, really, that even with your qualifications, you're still going to need to do a bit of that. You're still going to need to be able to present yourself and to why you are a good person to be employed. And that comes from having confidence in yourself, and what you've all achieved today will go some part to do that. And start of building your brand. You are a brand, and how are you then going to go and sell that in the outside world? And certainly given that the world is changing, you're going to need to be on top of that. So I talked my way into a job as the first woman computer operator in a company called Hoskin Systems in West Bromwich, which is where I was living, and I was the first female. And that might sound a bit odd now, but the job that I went for, they needed somebody that was 18, a man, because you could say, experienced in computing, 5 O levels, 2 A levels, and a driver. And I was 17, a woman, no experience, no qualifications, and I couldn't drive. But I didn't see why that should stop me, because I felt that if I was there, then they could see what I felt I could see in myself. When I look back, I mean, I think I was quite precocious, but it worked. And I really talked to them about why I thought that I would be a good chance for them to take. And it worked out well, because I've now been running with my husband Kevin the IT company, which is next door to Port Vale, Synectics, and you know, we employ 360 people, and we work on fraud detection and prevention with banks, building societies and insurance companies in the UK and around the world. And so I would never have known when I sat at my school that I would end up where I've ended up now. In fact, when I was 40, I went back for a reunion, and I spoke to my maths teacher, and he said, oh, what are you doing? And we'd started Synectics, so I told him about that. And he said, I always knew you'd do well. And I said, you didn't, you'd assign me to the gutter. And he said, no, you were walking a path, and that you were always gonna fall one way or the other, and whichever way you fell, it was gonna be spectacular, because you had that spirit within you. He said, but there was something which said to me that you would fall the right way. And I'm pleased to say that I did. And that's what really drives me to do my community work and to work with young people in this area, because there's a lot of people exactly the same as I was when I was 17. And if people could listen to them in the way that I was listened to, and I was given that opportunity, then you could all be crazy and end up owning a football club when you're 62. Who knows? And for the Stoke City fans out there, it doesn't have to be Port Vale, you're all right. So again, well done. I'm really, really proud, and you've had a great opportunity. I think Newcastle College is a really high standard, and I've been very impressed with everything that I've seen there. And you've made the most of that, so well done with that. Enjoy the rest of your evening, and you know, best of luck at going forward. Be kind to yourself, be kind to others, and stay safe. And congratulations, well done.
On to our next category of awards, celebrating the success of our many apprentices we have in training at NSCG. An apprenticeship is an extremely demanding programme, as it combines full-time work alongside part-time study and assessment. At NSCG, we're training more than 1,800 apprenticeships on a range of programmes, working with more than 850 employers. We have achievement rates way in excess of the national average, and are recognised as one of the best college training providers in the country. The Outstanding Achievement Intermediate Apprenticeship Award and goes to Jane Williams. Jane is currently a healthcare support worker at County Hospital, and her assessor describes her as someone who is eager to learn and keen to develop in her role. A consultant radiologist in the department where Jane works describes her as having strong communication skills, which do a great job of reassuring anxious patients visiting the department for the first time. Jane has developed her organisation skills throughout her training and is now an integral part of the team. Congratulations, Jane. Our second award in the Outstanding Achievement Intermediate Level Apprentice Award goes to Carly Seaton. Carly is currently completing a customer service intermediate programme on the new standards and works for Minuteman Press as a customer service apprenticeship. Carly hasn't always had things easy, but her commitment to both her work and to her apprenticeship award is phenomenal. She always makes sure her apprentice programme work is of a high standard, and she takes pride and always pushes herself to do her very best. She hopes to continue with her current employer in a job that she enjoys. Well done, Carly. The Outstanding Achievement Award at intermediate apprenticeship level goes to Lucy Begley. Lucy is described as an extremely hardworking intermediate apprentice who has already expressed a desire to progress on to level 3 and indeed has been asking for level 3 work to help to get her prepared. Her employer describes her as hardworking, dedicated, someone who is conscientious and always goes above and beyond. The next steps for Lucy are an advanced apprenticeship in early years. Congratulations, Lucy. Our next category is the Outstanding Achievement Advanced Apprenticeship Award and goes to Catherine Donnelly. Catherine is a lead senior support worker at Belong Village in Newcastle. And throughout her studies, she's managed to combine the demanding work role alongside excellent performance in her qualification. Her employer says Catherine has shown excellent commitment to a level 3 programme, and she's used the qualification to improve her own performance and has in turn used this to support and upskill her team in order to improve the life of the customers they serve. Catherine hopes to continue working in the job that she loves and undertake further leadership and management courses in due course. Congratulations, Catherine. Our second winner in the Outstanding Achievement Advanced Apprenticeship category goes to Molly Killeen. Molly is working as a trainee accountant at Jackson's Accountants. Her assessor and teachers describe her as an outstanding apprentice who's recently passed the EPA for the Assistant Accounting Apprenticeship. She gained 83%, which is a merit, in the synoptic assessment, and an impressive 98% distinction level in her portfolio and professional discussion. Her efforts at work have been recognised, and she's now moved on to a new challenge, working in international accounts, something she relishes. Next steps are AAT at level 4 as part of a higher apprenticeship. Congratulations, Molly. As we just heard, an apprenticeship is no barrier to higher education. And this next award recognises the outstanding achievement of students who are in employment and undertaking higher level study as part of their higher apprenticeship. The award for the Higher Apprenticeship Students of the Year goes to Jenny Pratt. Jenny is currently completing a level 4 in business administration alongside her work role at Biddulph Primary Care Centre. During her level 4 programme, Jenny has dealt with changes in the focus of her job role, including stepping up to cover aspects of the practice manager role for a number of weeks. As such, Jenny attended meetings with doctors, took over payroll, very important, and also dealt with the office staff. All of this alongside never missing any aspect of her higher apprenticeship studies. A real credit to the centre and a real credit to NSCG. Well done, Jenny. And now it's time for another video showing the life of an apprentice and of apprenticeship training at NSCG. So unfortunate, but that's just alright.
I'm something special, baby. It's 'cause I was never broken by you.
Now we move on to our next category of employer awards. A key requirement of a top apprenticeship training programme comes from the support trainees receive from their employer. In addition, we are regularly asking employers to support us in other ways, such as providing extended work placements, student internships, being guest speakers, mentors. Our list of requests is endless. We are proud to work with many great companies, and deciding on the winners for the employer award categories is always extremely tough. The companies receiving the awards tonight are described by our staff team as excellent employers, committed to training not only their own staff, but also they go above and beyond in their wider contribution, helping us at college in our work to drive up the employability agenda and helping to promote the apprenticeship route as a real career option for young people and adults. In the Best New Employer category, the winner is West End Centre and Cafe. The centre started to provide 10-week placements for students who find work experiencing a little challenging. The manager Alison and the chef Paul go out of their way to support such students to ensure they have a successful and productive work experience, which helps build their social skills and self-confidence. We are hoping that the centre will be fully operational sometime soon and that more of our students can experience this fantastic work placement. Thank you very much. The second winner in the new employer category is the company Nails by Annabel. NSCG has worked with Nails by Annabel for a little over 12 months, and currently we have 12 apprentices in training. The NBA team speak and treat all of their young apprentices with respect and give them regular feedback on their progress and the skills they have achieved. They have taken many trainees to roadshow events in Manchester and London, allowing them to get involved in putting up the stand, talking to customers and helping to sell their products at home and abroad. Fantastic experience for our apprentices in this area. Our next category recognises the support and achievements of small employers. We have two winners in this category, and the first is More Care Day Opportunities. Anita and her team of staff have gone out of their way to support our students in order for them to have a successful and productive work experience at More Care. It goes without saying that at More Care they have a good understanding of the complex needs and difficulties their service users have, both physically and mentally, and they help our students adjust to the needs of the service users. I'm hoping that the college can build further working relationships with this fantastic small employer, and we look forward to working with More Care in the future. Congratulations. The second award winner in our Best Small Employer category goes to Minuteman Press. A double award winner tonight, we had Carly, who received an intermediate award earlier this evening. Minuteman Press are run by a couple who work tirelessly to keep the business going, but also to support their trainees and workforce. Currently, they have two apprentices with us, and we've worked with Minuteman Press for around 4 years. My assessor, with over 25 years assessing experience, says that they've dealt with many different companies, but they can honestly say that Minuteman Press is one of the best companies they have ever dealt with. They work closely with the assessor and NSCG, ensuring that they provide not just a place of work, but also provide an atmosphere of support, care, and dedication for their workforce. These companies are hard to come by, and we are proud to work with Minuteman Press. Congratulations. Our next category is the Large Employer Award. The first winner of this award is STP Workforce. NSCG has worked with STP Workforce for more than 10 years, and it's fair to say it's a constantly evolving and very close partnership. Not only do we work together to support apprentices in training, but we also actively work together to promote more young people and adults considering coming into apprenticeships in the health and social care area. We are really proud to recognise the achievements of STP Workforce and look forward to working with them for many years in the future. Congratulations. Our second winner in the Best Large Employer category is ABB Limited. NSCG has worked with ABB Limited for more than 10 years, and together we have supported the training of more than 30 apprentices, an engineering and technology-focused international company who provide great support for each and every one of their trainees. As an example, the training manager from ABB regularly comes into college to see the apprentices as part of their off-the-job programme, discussing their progress on their practical and academic studies. On many occasions, the company has funded apprentices to continue to develop themselves beyond their apprenticeship programme. And we have many ABB apprentices who progress through to higher education and onto a foundation degree. Congratulations, ABB Limited. Our final award in the employer category is the Employer of the Year, and the award winner is TT Pumps. Steve Millwood, one of our assessors, has worked with TT Pumps since he started at the college in 2003. He says that the company have always recognised the importance of investing in the apprenticeship programme long before incentives were introduced. The majority of the management in the company have been apprentices, so they understand the importance of training young people and bringing them into the business. When Steve first started working with the company, they employed less than 50 employees, and I think now they have more than 150. Fantastic growth. I hope that TT Pumps continue to be a successful and growing business, and I hope that they continue to work with NSCG. We are proud to be associated with this company and wish them every success in the future. Congratulations. And now for our next video, showing sport at NSCG.
Like a beast in the jungle, in the heat of the rumble, I ain't got nothing to lose. I've been fighting these hard times in the ghettos of my mind. Now it's victory that I choose. Yes, my soul is blessed, the king is born, my mind complex. I'm a bad, bad man. Ain't no one like me. Like a bull in a glass house, no bull about to smash out. Can't nothing stand in my way. I don't care what the place is, from the penthouse to pavement. You better hear what I say. Yes, my soul is blessed, the king is born, my mind confess. I'm a bad, bad man. Ain't no one like me. I'm a legend.
Moving on to the sports section of our event, sport is a big deal at NSCG. Our sports academy is open for all students on whatever course they study with us. The academy at Newcastle even has its own awards, which this year were of course held virtually a couple of weeks ago. Just like the professional sport, our annual sports calendar was cut short, finishing in March at the point of lockdown. But unlike the Premier League, we don't get the luxury of a restart. However, even with a shorter season, we've managed to squeeze a lot in with much success to report. Here's a taste. Winners of Category 1 football, Netball A finished top of the league when voided, having won every match. Our Netball B team equal top of the league when voided, again won every game. Volleyball in the National Knockout Cup final, and volleyball, boys and girls football all qualified for the National Championships. In fact, we had 38 students in total qualifying for the National Championships, which should have been held in April at Nottingham University. We've had 5 student athletes selected for National Honours, and in the AOC National Sport Awards, we won 3 out of 6 categories. I could go on. At tonight's event, we recognise our top athletes in the awards given out, starting with the Sport Volunteer of the Year, which goes to Anya Akbar. Anya is in her first year with us and from day one has wanted to get involved. A keen footballer, Anna plays in goal for our academy team and clearly loves the game. However, this award recognises her enthusiasm for volunteering, and she became our first NSCG female English colleges football activator. This involves travelling to various places across the Midlands to attend training camps, and then she uses her skills back in our local community, supporting the growth and development of female futsal and football. She's been involved in a number of competitions and various events, and even though these have ground to a halt at the moment, we're hoping that Anya can get involved in promoting physical activity and the sport she loves very soon. Congratulations. Our next award is the top team spot, and as usual, this is hotly contested. The Team of the Year award goes to the Andy Griffin Football Academy First Team Squad. The AGFA First Team won the English Schools Cup competition last year. Andy and the squad had the challenge to perform better in the AOC Category 1 League this year. There are a number of Category 1 leagues nationally, and prior to this season, we've never really been in contention, but this year was different. And someone with a functioning crystal ball must have seen an early close down, as the lads had actually won the league by February, so we had the result in the bag. In fact, the team only lost one game all season, which is a tremendous achievement. As Category 1 winners, they progressed to the playoffs against the other Category 1 winners and runners-up nationally. And we'd actually made it through 2 rounds and were in the national semi-finals when, unfortunately, the competition was stopped with no restart planned for this year. Also during the season, we've had lots of individual success. We've had one player sign professional papers with Altrincham FC, one player achieved national call-up, and 10 of the squad have been in regular contention in the very successful Staffordshire County team this year. A great season all round, despite the early shutdown. Congratulations. Now for a short video message from a Stoke City legend, Ricardo Fuller, a striker who scored many memorable goals, who local supporters today would like to have back on the field. Ricardo has kept busy since his days at Stoke, doing his coaching badges, and our students have been lucky enough to have him for a number of sessions at Newcastle.
Good day everyone, it's Ricardo Fuller here, formerly Stoke City striker. Hope all is well and your families are all safe. Just want to say congratulations to everyone who has been nominated for an award at the NSCG celebration event, and I am sorry that I cannot be here in person as I was last year. I would like to wish you all every success in your future careers, and I look forward to seeing some of you in the next academic year, where I will be hopefully involved in the Andy Griffin Football Academy. Remember now, Never do anything half-hearted, because if you do, you can expect half-hearted results. Aim for the sky. Give it your all, because only your best is good enough. Godspeed. God bless. Take care. One love.
Our final sports awards recognise the success of individual athletes. The awards are named after the sporting legend that was Gordon Banks OBE. Known by everyone in the world of football, part of the England World Cup winning team in 1966, and recognised as one of the best goalkeepers in the world at the peak of his career. To us, Gordon was so much more. Our sports centre at Newcastle is named after Gordon. He was a regular at the college, and up until his death last year, Gordon attended this event every year and personally handed out the awards in his name. At Newcastle, we have a statue of him holding the World Cup overlooking our sports pitches. And at its unveiling in 2016, Gordon was joined by Jack Butland, England and Stoke City goalkeeper. And in support of our event this evening, Jack has recorded a short message for us to listen to.
Hi guys, it's Jack Butland here. I just wanted to say on behalf of the club, a massive congratulations to all the nominees and award winners of your individual and team achievements this year. I'm sure you're all desperate to get back there in the sports that you love. I know I am. But in the meantime, keep fit, stay safe, and I will see you all soon. Cheers.
Thank you, Jack, and good luck with the rest of the season. On to our final sports awards. And we have three award winners this evening. The first Gordon Banks Award for Sporting Excellence goes to Jenny Hesketh. Jenny is working hard on a demanding 3A level programme. However, you know what they say about asking a busy woman. Jenny is able to pack more into a normal week than most people can achieve in a month or a year. She plays football at NSCG as part of the Andy Griffin squad and has captained the team to success at the West Midlands Regional Sports Championships earlier in the year. She gained selection for the English Colleges FA national team and has competed abroad, representing England in the Capu Mundi tournament in Rome, and she was even player of the match in one of the games. However, Jenny is multi-talented and can play with any shaped ball. She captains Leek Ladies Rugby Team and has been selected and involved with the Loughborough Lightning Regional Centre of Excellence and Loughborough Lightning Premier Tyrrell side. She's also been selected for the England Rugby Under-18 squad and has attended four training camps. The latest involved a match against Scotland. We've never had a student selected for the national squad in two different games, and lockdown hasn't stopped her success. She received an award in the main sports events earlier this month and also won the National AOC Top Female Athlete Award, announced live on Twitter in April. With a training programme that makes me out of breath even trying to read it, she still manages to find time to volunteer and help promote various sporting events at NSCG. A truly inspirational young sports person. Jenny has an offer from Bath in sports management, and she's definitely one to watch for the future. Congratulations, Jenny. Our second winner of the Gordon Banks Award for Sporting Excellence goes to George Chapman. George is on the first year of his Level 3 programme after successfully completing a Level 2 programme with us last year. A fantastic young man, and like Jenny, someone who has already achieved a national award, winning the National AOC Sport Disability Sportsperson of the Year Award announced during lockdown. How great is that? Doing well in his academic studies, George throws himself into various sporting activities, but it is for his particular success in wheelchair basketball that he's receiving this award tonight. Travelling to Sheffield, George has completed several GB training camps, which we hope will ultimately, through a partnership with Sheffield Hallam, lead on to a sports science degree at the university, alongside competing with the GB team. George and I often chat in the college when our paths crossed. I am so proud of everything he has achieved, but it's clear to me that there is more to come. Congratulations, George, well done. Our final winner of the Gordon Banks Award for Sporting Excellence goes to David Pereira. David is part of the successful AGFA first squad, so a double winner tonight. Only in his first year with us, yet already an integral member of the first team squad, David is one of those players who not only performs brilliantly on the pitch, but he's also someone who motivates and encourages others to play well. His abilities have already been noticed by others, and earlier this year he was selected for both the England Colleges and the England Schools teams, and with the latter he managed to squeeze in a week-long tour of Holland before everything ground to a halt. I very much hope we have a full season for David next year, and I look forward to hearing of his future successes on the pitch. Congratulations, David. And now for our second musical number, Becky's singing a song that's very apt for award winners. A Moment Like This. For some students, life and study is a little harder, and it takes a little more determination to find success. Our next special award of the evening is the Ellen Anderson Award, which goes to a student who has overcome adversity in order to succeed. This year, the Ellen Anderson Award goes to Ethan Barlow. Ethan is a level 3 graphic student who has a severe visual impairment. This means in order for him to do his work, he requires magnification for all tasks, which is time consuming and very tiring on the eyes. He has support in class to help access information and occasionally requires some physical assistance to guide him with accuracy and the presentation of his work. These things can be seen as obstacles and an excuse to give up, or challenges which you can overcome. Fortunately, Ethan chooses the latter approach, and he's working extremely hard, achieving targets and deadlines, and working well through the lockdown period. He has expanded his artistic and accuracy skills through his programme and has shown total commitment to achieve his goal, which is to progress onto university. I'm pleased to say Ethan has secured a place at Wolverhampton, and we wish him the very best next year. Congratulations. Every successful college needs effective support and challenge from its governing body, which I'm pleased to say is absolutely the case at NSCG. George Stonier was chairman of Newcastle College for more than 20 years, steering the college through to the merger with Stafford College in 2016 and the formation of the Newcastle and Stafford College Group. Passionate about the opportunities FE can provide for students, our next special award is given to a student who has progressed over time spent at college, building skills, confidence, and achievement. The George Stonier Award goes to Cassie Pope. As a care leaver, Cassie has had to overcome significant personal barriers in life. Starting with us on a Level 2 programme, now 3 years later, she's just completed a Level 3 extended diploma in health and social care and is set to achieve high grades beyond her initial forecast targets. High-level study such as this is not easy without the traditional family support, but Cassie doesn't dwell on her own problems. Instead, she focuses on helping others. For example, she runs a church youth group, which is currently running using Zoom. As a vulnerable student, we've been able to see Cassie in college during the lockdown period, and despite a recent bereavement, she continued to support her peers through this rather anxious period. Cassie hopes to progress onto an apprenticeship with the NHS, and we wish her every success in the future. Finally, to our last two awards, chosen by me out of all the nominations, and they recognise outstanding academic and vocational performance of two students. The Principal's Award, Vocational, goes to Eden Blanche. Eden has completed a Level 3 extended diploma in business, achieving top grades throughout her programme. At the beginning, she was a rather quiet and reserved student, but she's now described by lecturers as an outstanding, independent, and self-confident lady who is an absolute joy to teach. Receiving a High Flyers Award in her first year, she is a member of the Future Leaders Academy at college, taking all the opportunities available to get the most out of her college experience. She also won the Tesla Future Leaders Day by working with a team to devise the most original and well thought out proposal based on innovation, marketing, and finance challenges. Eden has taken on extra responsibilities and represented her student cohort at the student conference this year. And throughout lockdown, she's continued to impress despite working throughout this period in food retail. With various university offers, I think it might be Falmouth next for Eden to study business and management. Congratulations. My second and the final award of the evening is the Principal's Award Academic and goes to Benjamin Millward. An A-level student, Ben is taking four A-level subjects, in the tough subjects, maths and sciences. Predicted the top grades in excess of his initial targets. He's a student who seems to have relished the intellectual challenge presented by his programme of study at college. Ben is a previous Student of the Month winner and has benefited from support in his university application, which he fully engaged with. A natural flair for maths and science, he has secured a place at Cambridge to study natural sciences. Ben will be the first in his household to attend university, so with an offer from one of the top universities in the world for one of their most competitive programmes, that's not too bad. Congratulations, Ben. We wish you every success in the future. That brings us to the end of our virtual celebration evening. I hope you've enjoyed it, but before I go, I must say a few thank yous. First, a big thank you for the many special guests who took the time to record video messages for us. Thank you so much for joining us this evening. Thank you to my team who've pulled this celebration event together. It's always a huge piece of work, and this year it's had the technological aspects just to make it even more tricky. Particular thanks to Denise and Lindsay and their team, and John for the sound, and of course Becky for her two beautiful musical pieces. My biggest thanks this year goes to Joe, our marketing manager, and to Dan, our cameraman and film editor and producer. You wouldn't believe what they've had to put up with. They've been very patient with me. Actually, here you are watching. Thank you both. My final words are to our successful award winners, many of whom are leaving us this time. Be proud of your achievements tonight, and thank you for your contribution to our college. And as you go forward in your lives, try and remember to always demand more from yourself. Be determined and resilient, even in the face of repeated failure. Dream big and go further than you thought you could. And in all things, show respect and be kind to yourself, to other people, and of course to our planet. Take care, everyone. Thank you.